A man comes to see Imam al-Sajjad alayhi salam, he finds him weeping. Brothers and sisters, subhanAllah, we hear of Karbala. We did not see it. We hear it. Yet it is so living. It is as if we are living it. You see the mu'mineen crying over something that they are listening to, they're hearing it. Something that happened 1,380 years ago exactly. And you're crying. Imam al-Sajjad did not just hear about it, he lived it. So a man came one day to see him, saw him weeping, crying. He says, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, take it easy on yourself. He says, what are you talking about? Yaqub lost one son, and he was alive, Yusuf. He cried so much that he lost his eyesight for him because of his love to him. And I witnessed the killing, the martyrdom of 18 of my family members. Faces so bright like the moon in the middle of the night were killed right in the front of my eyes. Yaqub cried and cried for his son Yusuf alayhi salam, even though he knew he was alive. I say, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Then what was your state when you saw your son Ali al-Akbar getting killed right in front of your eyes? When all the companions were killed, Al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam stood and he started crying, هَلْ مِنْ نَاصِرٍ يَنْصُرُنَا هَلْ مِنْ مُعِينٍ يُعِينُنَا هَلْ مِنْ طَالِبٍ لِلْجَنَّةِ يَطْلُبُنَا هَلْ مِنْ ذَابٍ يَذُبُّ عَنْ حَرَمِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Is there anyone to support us? Is there anyone to help us? I say, Ya Aba Abdullah Sayyidi, here are your followers, your lovers in this majlis, crying, they're attending here, their attendance is your support. Is there anyone to help us? Is there anyone to support us? Is there anyone who is seeking Jannah who would come and join us? Is there anyone who would stand to defend the women and the children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We are the family of Rasulullah, and this is what those people are doing to us. At that point, he finds a beautiful shining moon, full moon coming out of the tent. He looks at him. This is the first of the family of Ahlul Bayt. Who is he? His son Ali al-Akbar. A man who most resembled Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi in his looks, in his features, in his characteristics, in his manners, in the way he spoke. He came to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein walking with utmost humbleness, utmost respect, stands in the front of his father and says, Abi, hal ta'dhal li bil khuruj? Do you give me the permission to go out and fight? Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam looked at his son Ali al-Akbar. He knew that once he goes, he will be martyred. It is difficult for a loving, compassionate father like Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam to tell his son, yes son, go ahead and get killed. Rather, what Imam al-Hussein does, he raises his hands in dua. He said, Allahumma ashhad ala ha'ula'il qawm. إنهم دعونا لينصرونا ثم عدوا علينا يقتلونا وقد برز إليهم الآن أشبه الناس خلقا وخلقا ومنطقا بنبيك وكنا كلما اشتقنا إلى النظر إلى نبيك نظرنا إليه. Oh Allah, bear witness on those enemies of yours. They invited us to support us, to help us. Then they turned against us and started killing us. And now a man who most resembles your messenger in his looks, in his characteristics, in his manners, in his features, and in his speech is about to go fight them. Oh Allah, punish them, Ya Allah. Don't let them go unpunished. Ali al-Akbar then realizes this is the permission of his father. He's given the permission. So Ali al-Akbar then rides his horse like a lion, just like his grandfather Ali, salamullahi alayh, comes to the battlefield. He was about 27 years old on the day of Ashura, what historians say. Ali al-Akbar comes, this young man, now he comes to the battlefield and he starts calling, أنا علي ابن الحسين ابن علي نحن وبيت الله أولى بالنبي والله لا يحكم فينا ابن الداعي أضربكم بالسيف حتى يصطلي ضرب غلام هاشمي علوي. I am Ali, the son of Hussein, the son of Ali. I am from the Prophet's family. I will fight against you bravely. The enemies of Allah will not be ruling over us. And indeed, he starts fighting bravely like a lion, killing the enemies right and left. They disperse away from him. One of the enemies, a man who was well known to be valor, to be brave, comes to him. Ali ibn Akbar fights with him and strikes him and kills him. When they see that, they get scared. So they start moving away from Ali al-Akbar. Umar ibn Sa'd, la'natullahi alayh, says, fight him from a distance. Don't go near him. If you go near him, you will all be killed. So everyone stay away from a distance. Just shoot him with arrows and shoot him with rocks. So they started shooting him. Then he managed to get away from them and he comes back to his father. He says, Aba thiqlu al-hadid ajhadani Aba al-atash. My father Imam Hussein, it is hard, I'm carrying all this metal on me. I am thirsty, oh father. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam looked at him. He said, son, be patient. It is only a few minutes from now and you will be quenched. Your thirst will be quenched by your grandfather Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Brothers and sisters, look at how great Ali al-Akbar is. One would wonder, why would he come and ask his dad for water? Doesn't he know there is no water? Yes, he does. But he wanted to ease his loss on the heart of his father, so that when he is killed, his father would say, at least your thirst was quenched. He wanted to ease the difficulty of the law. It is difficult for a father to see his son killed right in front of his eyes. Ali al-Akbar thought about that. How can I make it a bit easier on my father? I will tell him I am thirsty so that he knows death is a relief for me. That would a little bit make it easier on my father. His father says, be patient, son. It is only a matter of minutes, and your thirst will be quenched by your grandfather, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He wants to head back to the battlefield. He tells him, son, before you go back, go see your mother inside the tent. She's waiting for you. He goes inside the tent, the women, his sisters, his aunts, they all gather around him. They said, Ali, Ali, Ali. Don't leave, don't go. We don't want to see you killed, covered in your blood. He tells them, I have to make you all proud of me in front of my grandmother, Fatima al-Zahra. Oh Allah, you brought Yusuf back to Yaqub. Bring my son Ali back to me one last time. Let me see him. Allah answers the call of this mother, this desperate mother. He brings her Ali back. She opens her eyes. She finds him standing right there. She says, son Ali. Oh, my son Ali. You're about to leave. He says, yes, mother. I will make you proud on the day of judgment in front of my mother, Fatima. Yes, son, go back to the battlefield. He goes back to the battlefield. He starts fighting again like a lion, until the enemies of Allah surround him from all sides. They start showering him with their arrows. Some of their arrows reach him. They reach his chest. Another enemy of Allah comes and strikes him with a sword over his head. رحم الله المنادي أيوا عليا He put his head on the eyes of his horse, on the head of the horse. The blood then came on the eyes of the horse. The horse couldn't see where it's going. So instead of taking him back to the camp of Imam al-Hussein, he takes him to the camp of Umar ibn Sa'd. That's when the enemies strike him with their sword, right, left, and center, until the horse then turns around, comes back. At that point, Ali then calls, Aba ya Hussein, alayka minni salam. Oh, father, Imam Hussein, salam to you from me. Here is my grandfather, Rasulullah. He's just given me a drink of water that has quenched my thirst. And this is my mother, Fatima. She is telling you that they are awaiting you in Jannah. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam comes rushing to his son Ali al-Akbar. Ali al-Akbar collapses from his horse to the grounds of Karbala. Imam al-Hussein throws himself from the horse to the body of his son, and he cries, cry with him, Waladi Ali. Everyone, Waladi Ali. Louder, waladi. Ah, bunay, ala dunya ba'dak al-afa. Oh, my son, it is difficult for your father to see you in such a state, cut in pieces with the arrows, the spears, and the swords. Ah, I wish I would not have lived to see this moment. قطع الله رحمك يا ابن سعد كما قطعت رحمي. Oh, Umar ibn Sa'd, may Allah make you feel this pain that you've just made me feel. And Ali al-Akbar's life, it ends on the chest of Imam al-Hussein, salamullahi alayh. Then he called Bani Hashim, come and carry Ali back to the tent. They come, they carried Ali back to the tent. His aunt Zainab came rushing, crying, Waladi Ali, my son Ali. The sisters came, cried, oh, our brother Ali, ya Ali al-Akbar, covered in blood. My son, I never expected to see you in such a state. I had wished one day you would be burying me, not me looking at you covered in blood. يا ابني يا ابني قطعت منك نصيبي أنا ردتك ذخر الأيام شيبي. آه إنا لله إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين.